ever been told that you just aren't good enough, or that you can't do engineering because you're just a girl? Well, we have, and that's what drives our passion and gives us the adrenaline to push ourselves so we can portray that we can do anything we set our minds to.
For far too long, discriminatory stereotypes have prevented women and girls from having equal access to education in STEM. Well, that's something we both knew we wanted to change. Team Blaze is the first and the youngest all-girls team to ever represent India at the F1 in Schools World Finals. Hi, I'm Amaira, the Resource, Finance, and Sponsorship Manager for Team Blaze.
And I'm Jasmeh, the Team Manager and Manufacturing Engineer for Team Blaze. Did you know that only 14% of Indian women have jobs in STEM? And out of that, 81% of them face gender bias. We are a team that has experienced this on a personal level. We've constantly been told by people on social media that girls just shouldn't do engineering, that we aren't good enough for the sport, but we didn't let that stop us.
We know that these stereotypes are wrong. As Lakshmi Puri, former secretary of the UN, once said, they deny women and girls a chance to realize their potential and deprive the world of half its population's ingenuity and innovation.
F1 in Schools is a perfect opportunity for us to promote female rights and women in motorsports.
Our identity is built around challenging and rejecting stereotypes about gender, age, and who can and can't be in STEM. We use our identity to rise up to these challenges and to reject negative stereotypes.
We promote the whole F1 in Schools experience. Science, technology, engineering, and mathematics is the key to our future, to new developments that will benefit us all, and to a sustainable planet, issues that matter to young people.
We stand for the power of what we can achieve together. By sharing our experiences, we empower other young women to pursue their own dreams. We did this through collaborations with FIA Women in Motorsports, Mission Aditi, and our own talk show called Burning Questions with Blaze, where we promote and engage with other F1 in Schools teams.
Let's take a look at women in motorsports.
As 13-year-olds, we wanted to see more women in motorsports. F1 is a male-dominated field, but we wanted to bridge that gap. There are already a number of very successful females working in F1, but we need to provide young girls and women more opportunities so that they can get into STEM.
On the positive side, people have started to see the large scope and opportunity in STEM and are doing various activities to get girls to take part. A very famous Formula E racer said that the motorsport industry will explode in the next 10 years as females are finally getting the opportunity to showcase their dedication, potential, and talent.
In order to make a difference through actions, we collaborated with Fédération Internationale de Automobile, also known as FIA Women in Motorsports. They agreed to the collaboration due to aligned goals, and their support helped us spread positive messages out in the real environment. We use digital media platforms to engage with young female drivers, such as Ashi Hanspal, who is a part of FIA's Rising Star program.
The F1 in Schools World Finals took place in June of 2021, where we were the first Indian team to ever win an award at the World Finals. We were nominated for the Women in Motorsports Award, Best Team Identity, and Best Research and Development. We won the Best Project Management and PID Display Award. We were not only nominated for 5 awards and won 2, but were declared the best Asian team of the competition.
Through this experience, we're hoping to spread the message that you can do whatever you set your mind to, no matter your age or your gender.
We worked with girls in STEM, but through our talk show called Burning Questions with Blaze, and did various activities too.
We worked with little girls and boys from a foundation called Little League and engaged them using activities based to STEM. We also run online events specifically to support F1 in Schools teams in India that are just starting out. We released an original song called Dear Future Stars on Spotify for all the girls out there. It talks about our journey and the challenges we faced as an all-girls team.
In order to support our vision of empowering young girls, we collaborated with Mission Aditi. Mission Aditi is an organization that supports education for sanitation. We together believe that sanitation and menstrual hygiene should be a right and not a privilege.
A large group of girls in rural areas are uneducated about menstrual hygiene until they get their first period. Additionally, these young girls feel very uncomfortable during these times due to the taboo associated with it.
Due to this, they use unhygienic methods and don't even attend school. The word periods and pads are almost a taboo in rural areas of India. Together, we wanted to provide young girls with biodegradable sanitary pads that would help reduce the stigma while making sure we're not polluting the environment.
We believe that science and progress go hand in hand with sustainability by depleting natural resources and therefore supporting long-term ecological balance, which is also what we look for in the companies we collaborate with.
Together with Mission Udithi, we collected 2,940 sanitary pads through a pad drive. We got a great response from the girls at the Meher Baba Charitable Trust, which shows that small actions that we take as young girls can make a huge difference in the community.
Overall, our Formula One in Schools journey has been one with great learning in technical aspects, but most importantly, life lessons.
We learned that if you don't believe in yourself and your dreams, nobody ever will.
We learned that you have to follow your dreams and aspirations and to not let the hate break you down. We were the first all-girls team from India at the F1 in Schools World Finals, the first team from India to win an award at the F1 in Schools World Finals, and the best overall Asian performance. We were the first, but we will make sure we aren't the last.
And lastly, we urge all the girls out there to take part in STEM and for the society to be more accepting of these opportunities, since they can help future contributions and more. If anyone doubts your capabilities, be that girl that straps in, puts on a helmet, and breaks all the stereotypes that try to cage you in.
Thank you.